And to see the fifth lesson in past and present from tired as to rulers. We can understand some important ideas from this headline. The tired as to rulers. The tired as becomes as a rulers. In India, the tired as they are coming to India for trade and they become as a rulers. India is a Asian country, no? In the Asian continent or India is located. The Europeans wants to know the knowledge, wants to know about the fertility of India, and they are coming to India for trade. First, the Europeans are coming as a traders. Only the Europeans only came to India as a traders. First, the English East India Company is coming to India. First, the English East India Company, the French, Anglo, like that, the Portuguese. Like that the people came to India for trade. First we can see the English East India Company. The English East India Company was formed in the year 1600. In this time the Queen Elizabeth is giving the permission to form the trade in India to the English people. They are giving the permission, they have formed that company, and in the year 1612 the company set up its first factory in Surat. The East India's company's first factory was set up in Surat, that is near to Mumbai. The French East India Company, they are foreign country, that European country, the France, no? They are coming and they are formed, that French East India Company formed in India in the year 1664. They have formed their country, they formed their company in Ehim, Mahe, Enam and Karikal, and they have formed as Pondicherry as their headquarters. And the French East India Company was largely controlled by the French government, and heavily they have given the French government given the military support and the financial support to that company. Then the Anglo-French, we can see the Anglo-French rivalry. The English East India Company is formed in the year 1600 and the French East India Company formed in the year 1664. Here you see both the two are the foreign European countries, no? Both they are the rivalry between that Anglo-French companies. You see in the year nearly 20 years, 1744 to 1763, the French and English, that Anglo-French clash was thrice there the clash between these two countries and the two companies, and there is a clash between these two companies for 20 years. There are three wars in India. They are coming to India for the war. You see, they are coming to India for the trade, but here they have strengthened their power. The military support also they are getting from their countries, and here they are began to war between these two countries. In India they are coming to trade, and there is the rivalry between the English and French. You see, the first war is lasted for 20 years. Three wars held in India between these two European countries. First Carnatic War held in the year 1744 and 1748. There the 4 years this war was held. In it, that British only got a victory. The French led to by Dupleix. The French headquarters is Pondicherry, no, on that time, no. The Dupleix is the leader. Then the Carnatic Nawab and British, that British and French
there is a rivalry in the year 1744 to 1758. After the first Carnatic War, that Madras was returned to the British. Then the second Carnatic War was started in the year 1748 and it is lasted in the year 1754. In this second Carnatic War also between the British and the French. Because of the issue of succession to the throne in Hyderabad and Carnatic. After the peace treaty, the second Carnatic War was came to an end. After that, from France, he is recalled to France. Then we can see the third Carnatic War. In the third Carnatic War, 1756 to 1763, third Carnatic War was started. That is ended in the year 1763. There is no peace between this French and British. They are fighting in India. In the year that problem broke out in Europe also in the year 1756. And they have signed a peace treaty in the year 1763. Then the French given back their factories in India, but were not allowed to fortify them. Then you see that after that only the French influence was declined and the British went on to become the masters of India. The British traders. The foreign traders, European traders, are becomes as a ruler in India.